ओके आय प्रोफेसर आकाश गावडे फ्रॉम राजमाता जिजाऊ शिक्षण प्रसारक मंडळ इंस्टिट्यूट ऑफ कॉम्प्युटर अँड मॅनेजमेंट रिसर्च ऍट एमबीए डिपार्टमेंट. टुडे आय एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विथ यू अ सब्जेक्ट प्रोजेक्ट मॅनेजमेंट हॅविंग सब्जेक्ट कोड 308. इन दिस सब्जेक्ट आय एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विथ यू अ चॅप्टर 2 प्रोजेक्ट प्लॅनिंग. ओके लेट्स सी फ्रॉम द पार्ट नंबर 1. इन दिस चॅप्टर 2 प्रोजेक्ट प्लॅनिंग ओके today we are discussing about the some key points. Okay, let's see the key points are the importance of estimating time and cost, factors influencing the quality of estimates, estimating guidelines for time, cost and resources, methods of project estimation, and the last one is methods of estimating time accurately. Let's see in brief one by one. The first one is you are the importance of estimating time and cost. Okay, as all know, okay, whenever you are going to make a particular planning of a particular product or project, okay, at that time you must have to estimate the time and cost required for the particular product to complete it. Okay, let's see what are the importance of estimating time and cost. Okay, the first one is your to support good decision. Okay, to schedule work to be done, to determine how long the project should take, to determine the project cost, to determine whether the project is worth doing, to develop cash flow needs, to determine how well the project is progressing, and the last one is to develop the time phased budget and estimate the project baseline. Okay, whenever you are going to fulfill the requirement of the customer, okay, at that time you must have to consider, okay, how much the time is required to complete the customer requirement. Okay, for the input of the customer requirement to the delivery of the product. Okay, at that time you must have to consider, okay, how much the cost of the project will be. Okay, by considering the number of types of processes which you are going to do on the particular product to complete the customer requirement. Okay, that's why there is a estimation of a time and cost. Okay, as you consider the time, how long the project is going on. Okay, that means if you will get the alternate same project, okay, at the same time. Okay, that means if you are making the particular perfect planning of a particular project, that means you will get a time span to complete the another project also. Okay, that means this is your the estimation of a time and cost must be necessary, okay, to reduce the cost of the product and to deliver the particular product to the customer within the time. The next one is your the factors influencing the quality of estimates. Okay, there are some factors, okay, which influence the quality of the product. Okay, the first one is planning horizon, project duration, people. The next one is project structure and organization. Next, padding estimates. Next, organization culture. And the last one is other non-project factors. Okay, let's see. Okay, as the past experience is a good starting point for developing time and cost estimate, but that must be further refined to the current project. Okay, there are some factors. See, whenever you are going to make a particular time estimation and the cost estimation of a particular product, okay, at that time you must have to consider, okay, your the past experience of the same project. Okay, that means it will be helpful to you to complete the particular project within the time and to reduce the cost of the particular project. Okay, the first one is your the planning horizon. Okay, it means planning horizon means what? It is related to the accuracy of time and cost estimate. Okay, that means it should improve as the project moves from the conceptual phase to the point where individual work packages are defined. This is your the planning horizon. The next one is your the project duration. Okay, project duration. Okay, some of the project having the low duration time to complete it, some of the project having the large amount of duration of time. Okay, see, in case of a car manufacturing industry as compared to your the aeroplane manufacturing industry, the car manufacturing industry require a less time as compared to your the aeroplane manufacturing industry. Okay, this is your the time lag between the two project. Okay, you that means you must have to consider how much the duration of the project is. Okay, long duration project increases the uncertainty in estimates. The price of technology may decrease over time. How your labor, equipment, and operations are likely to increase over the same period, but at what rate, how much, how can that be accurately estimated? Just a bit. Sorry for the disturbance. Okay, project duration. Okay, see, right now you know that okay, there is a labor shortage out there. Okay. If you are taking the project in February month, okay, at that time there is no labor shortage. Okay, lot of number of the labors are available. Okay, and the cost of the labor is less. But right now, due to the pandemic situation, you know that there is only the less amount of the labor are available, and also the labor costs are will be increased. That's why, okay, as the duration of the project is long, that means if you are estimating the time cost of the particular project and the duration of the project is long, that means you can't be calculate accurately the cost of the project. Okay, because you don't know the uncertainty happens in the future. That's why the project duration, okay, must be less as possible. Okay, we cannot say less, but we can say it is a right calculation of the particular duration of the particular project. Okay, that means right time, okay, of the particular duration of the project, it must be needed. The second one, the next one is your the people. Okay, let's see, the people factor can introduce challenges in the estimating processes. A close match of a skill to the task will influence productivity and learning time, and conversely the opposite is also true. Staff turnover and whether people have worked on project together in the past also influence accurate estimating. Okay, see, people, the skill of your the people, okay, your organization, okay, using the skill manpower for the particular project as per the requirement of the project. We cannot say the skill manpower, okay, because sometimes we need a unskilled manpower also. Okay, as depending on the project, okay, your organizations having a that type of a skill of the employee are available, based on that, okay, your the quality of the product must be determined. Okay, if you needed a skilled manpower and your organization doesn't have it, that means there is a influence on your the quality of the product. You can't estimate the quality of the product as far as accurately. Okay, that's why the people must be needed as per the requirement of the particular product. Okay, you are going to manufacture a aeroplane, okay, but your organization's having only the designer engineer, okay, that having only the qualification, or that only have the knowledge to manufacture the car or design a car, that doesn't have the knowledge to manufacture or design the particular aeroplane, that means there is a lack of the quality of the particular aeroplane. Okay, this is your the related to the people. The next one is your the project structure and organization. Okay, the project structure refers to matrix, functional and projectized, the speed advantages of a focused dedicated team comes at a higher cost than a matrix team. However, the matrix team will not deliver as quickly due to competing demands and divided focus. project structure. Okay, the structure of the project. Okay, we can say if anything problems happens in the workflow, okay, that type of problems, okay, directly inform to your the manager, or there is a certain authority are available to resolve your problem. Okay, that means such type of a structure must be needed. Okay, that's why the quality of the product will be improved. Okay, otherwise there is a lack of the quality of the your product. The next one is a padding estimate. Okay, when us to estimate, most are inclined to pad estimates in order to increase the probability of being on budget and reducing the risks of being late. Padding, however, defeats the chance of truly arriving at a realistic estimate, which is greatly needed in order to be competitive. See, padding estimate means it is one type of your the pandemic situation. Okay, that means duration of the project must be less as possible. Okay, as the duration of the project increases, you can't be estimate the cost of the project accurately and also the quality of the product accurately. Okay, see, that's why this is a padding estimate. The next one is your the organizational culture. Okay, some organization tolerate padding, other encourage it, still other oppose it. It takes time to properly prepare estimates. It is the bedrock of effective project management. Okay, you can see organization culture. Okay, you know that the organization culture matters about your the cost of the product, the quality of the product. Okay, we can compare, or you must have to compare the organization culture of your the Mahindra and Mahindra related to the Tata Motors, compared to your the VW, compared to your the Mercedes Benz. Okay, depending on the organization, because the customer has a mindset. Okay, in case of a Mercedes, this is a branding status of the Mercedes in the customer's mind. This is all related to your the organization culture. Okay, the next one is your the other non-project factors. Okay, equipment downtime, holidays, vacations, staff reduction, strikes, and legal limits influence project estimates. Okay, this is a big issue in every organization. Okay, the worker strikes. If the workers are not satisfied about their payment, workers are not satisfied about their the organization's culture, that means the certain uncertainty will be arises, and your the employees will make a strike. Okay, you must have to consider that type of a factors also whenever you are going to make a planning about your the project. You must have to consider this type of a factor. The first one is your the planning horizon, project duration, people, project structure and organizations, padding estimates, organization culture, and the last one is other non-project factors. Okay, let's see. The next one is your the estimating guidelines for time, cost and resources. The first one is your the responsibility, second time units, third independence, fourth one is your the contingencies, and the fifth one is your the adding risk assessment to the estimates. Okay, let's see. In case of your responsibility, okay, those who are the most familiar with the task should make the estimates. If the others are consulted instead, it will be difficult to hold those doing the work responsible for not achieving the estimated time. 1 minute. Okay, responsibility. Okay, that means whenever you are estimating the particular time and cost and resources of your the related to yours the project, you must have to make a responsible person. Okay. Okay, who is the responsible for the particular activity? You must have to divide the particular task to the particular person. Okay, this is a responsibility. Okay, you must have to give the particular task to your the particular employee. That means it will be completed within the time, and the cost of the particular task will be reduced. Or we can say, whatever you are estimated the particular cost for the particular task, it will be remain same. Okay, the next one is your the next one is your the independence. Okay, treat each task independently. Do not aggregate time or cost upward. Each task is to have its own value. See, whenever you are dividing the particular task to the particular employee, okay, if there are four employees and you are dividing the four tasks to the four employees, okay, you must have to consider the independence activity of the particular employee. Okay, independence task you must have to calculate it. Okay, you do not go for to compare the, you must have to compare the all four activities which you are divided into the your four employee. Okay, you must have to consider independently. Okay, not in a group basis. Okay, this is your the independence, because it will be easily helpful to you. Okay, how much the time will be required, okay, and how much you are spent for their quality. The next one is your the contingencies. Okay, work packages estimates should not include allowances for contingencies. Remember, the estimate should assume normal conditions, but expect that not all work packages will materialize as a plan. See, contingency, it is all related to your the planning of a particular project. If the someone is perform a better or make a overtime, if you are giving the particular task to the particular employee to complete within 1 hour, but the employee required or the employee completed that particular task more than the 1 hour, okay, for the extra time, okay, which the employee are taking taking over your the 1 hour, okay, for that particular time your organization has a duty to do not pay for them, because as you are paying for that also, that means your duration of the project will be also increased and the cost of the product also will be increased. Okay, that's why this is your the contingencies. You must have to give the particular task to the particular employee, or you can say in a group, and say them to complete within that time period also. If they required more than that time, the employee will not get nothing for that. Okay, the last one is your the adding risk assessment to the estimates. Okay, this helps to avoid a surprises to the stakeholders. Unexpected time delays or cost increases should be identified as possible risks to the project. use a PRT. PRT. Okay. We will see PRT time estimates for optimistic, most likely, and worst case scenario for tasks that are valid. See, in the before slide, what we discussed, whenever you are going to make a planning of a particular project or estimating the quality of the product, you must have to consider this point. Okay. All these points are comes under the adding risk assessment to the estimate. Because see, if your project are completed within the time, that means your cost of the particular project will be remain same. If the time period for completing the project will be increased, that means alternately the cost of the project also will be increased. That's why your organizations, okay, consider all these types of influences. The first one is planning horizon, project duration, people, project structure and organizations, planning estimates, organization culture. And the last one is you are the other non-project factors. Okay. Next one is your the five successful methods of project estimation. Okay. The first one is your the expert judgment. The second one is your the comparative or analogous estimation. The third one is your the top down. Fourth one is your the bottom up. And the last one is your the parametric model estimating. Okay. See, project estimation is hard. Why? It is because the only time you know precisely how long it takes to complete a project is when it's done up to the point of delivery. Teams use educated guesswork to predict the futures and the bigger and more complex a project is. Faulty estimates mean missing deadlines and breaking budgets, two of the main symptoms of the project failure. The first one is you are the missing deadline and the breaking judgment. Okay, this is the two main symptoms of project failure. Okay, being a skilled estimator is a crucial part of setting schedule, estimating budgets, managing resources, and running a thriving team and business. Here are the number of estimations of the methodologies are available. The first one is your the expert judgment. Okay, it means this is probably the most common way of people to get a project estimation. Talk to the men and women with the best hands-on experience and understanding of the project requirement. Just to make sure that everyone has the some understanding of what needs to be delivered and try to be find expert who will actually be working on the project. Let's see, if you are manufacturing a car, okay, and your organization having a design engineer of an aircraft, it is not possible to design a particular craft. At that time, you must have to need a design engineer of a car manufacturing industry only. That means this is your the expert judgment. Okay. The next one is your the comparative or analogous estimation. Okay. If your current project is similar to past ones, take the data from previous work and explore it to provide your estimation for the new job. Before proceeding, make sure and check whether those projects were successful. See, we already discussed in later. We are discussing in case of you are the project structures and organizations. Okay, let's see. Whenever you are doing a similar project in the future, okay, you must have to take, okay, which type of factors are influenced on your quality, on your the time duration of the particular project. Okay, that factor you must have to consider in the next similar project. This is your the comparative or analogous estimation. Okay. The next one is your the top down. Okay. Top down. Using a high level work breakdown structure and data from previous project, you can add estimates for each project work item to determine the overall efforts and cost. The top down methods lacks detailed analysis, which make it best suited for a quick first pass at a prospective project to assess its viability. The next one is your the bottom up. This method uses a detailed work breakdown structure and is best for project you are committed to. Each task is estimated individually and then those estimates are rolled up to give the higher level of numbers. This process makes you think that what's required in order to take a step back to see if the big picture still makes sense. You will receive more accurate result than the top-down methods, but it's also a greater investment of time. Okay, the top-down approach and bottom-up approach. Okay, we will discuss in next part. Okay, in brief, the next one is your the parametric model estimating. This is the more scientific method that essentially auto-calculate estimates using detailed data from previous activity. Let's say you have data from your last three office network installation project. You can use this to get a days per workstations value or something similar. You then plug in the number of workstations for your new installations and out pop the estimates. This can be quick method but needs robust data to feed it, and because it's all about the maths, it's hard to adjust or the environmental, political, and cultural differences. But see, parametric model estimating means what? Okay, this is all related to the calculation. Okay, you must have to take the previous data of your the similar project. Okay, and you have to use this data in your the recent project. That means your time estimation and cost estimation of your the recent project will be get easily and accurately. The next one is your the estimating time accurately. Calculating realistic project timeline. Okay, why estimate time accurately? Okay, let's see this. How you have been on a project where the deadline was way too tight. Okay, the chances are that temper were fried, the sponsors were unhappy, and team member were working ridiculous hours. Chances are too that this happened because someone understand the amount of work needed to complete the project. Okay, whenever you are estimating a particular project, okay, who is the sponsor of your the project? Okay, and how much the duration of the project to complete it? There are few minutes are there. Okay. Whenever you are finding the particular sponsor, okay, to make a finance for your the project, okay, he will also ask you how much the time duration to complete the particular project. As the duration of the project is large, that means the finance required for your the project is also large. At that time, okay, the sponsor, okay, will also, you must have to give the guarantee to the sponsor that, okay, he will get more than that, okay, what he had invested right now. This is your estimating time accurately. Okay, the next one is your, why estimate time accurately? Why there is a right time estimation of your, the time is needed, okay? We already seen why the estimation of a time accurately is needed. The first one is As the duration of the project increases, the cost of the project also will be increases. Okay, and as the duration of the project is more, you don't know about what type of uncertainty happens, and the cost of the project will be increased. That's why the right time estimation is needed. Okay, to make the particular project within the particular time duration and with the estimated cost. Okay, accurate time estimation is a crucial skill in a project management. Without it, you won't know how long your project will take, and you won't be able to get a commitment from the people who need to sign it off. Even more importantly for your career, sponsors often judge whether a project has succeeded or failed depending on whether it has been delivered on time and on budget. To have a chance of being successful as a project manager, you need to be able to negotiate sensible budget and achievable deadline. If you are asking to some of the sponsor, okay, to make the finance for your the project, then sponsor asks you, okay, how much the duration of the project is, how long your the project is going on. Because okay, if anyone asks, anyone is sponsoring to your project, okay, at that time he also calculated that, okay, if the time duration is more or your project is delivering to the customer on a right time, okay, thus your project is delivering to the customer at a right time, then is it okay? Okay, the sponsor will get more than that. Okay, because there is a surety to the sponsor that he will his sponsoring or his finance, okay, will get more than that only when the project is delivered to your the customer at on a right time. Okay, let me stop here. Anybody having questions, you can ask me.